In this new series, we are going to create a project where we handle multiple things. One is multi-authentication, which essentially just means if a user logs in and they're a user, they'll be directed to one page. And if a user logs in as an admin, then they'll get logged into the admin side of things. And we are also going to build out just a very basic admin panel from scratch. Okay, so to show you what I mean, we'll go ahead and register user. Okay, register. And as you can see, they get sent straight to the default Laravel dashboard page. I didn't change anything about anything in here. Okay, but if we log out and we log in as an admin, okay, so admin at admin.com, password is password, enter, we are now sent to a dashboard page. Okay, so it's going to be really simple. If you click on the left, we have a menu down here. It's a drop-down menu. Everything, as I said, is made from scratch. So you can go to the admins page and you can see the list of admins. So we have their role, we have their name, the created at. We can also edit admins. Okay, we can change their title. Say change it to moderator. Okay. And then we have a sort of flash message up here. Super admin has been successfully updated, and super admin, that's the name, now has the role of moderator. Okay, and then we can do the same with roles. Okay, same thing. We can even create new roles. New role name. And as you can see up here, you see a preview of it. So submit. Role created successfully, and then we have the name, new role name. Okay, and also we have users, and these users, you can edit them, you can update them. Since it's an admin panel, all I did was set it up so that you can just change the role so that they go from user to, let's say, developer, and then change that. Okay, so super simple, super easy. We go back to the admins page, we'll see that user is now in our admins list. Okay, Sylvester Langworth, developer. Okay, fantastic. Then we also have here in the menu over here, the list, you can also go to the regular admins page or the regular dashboard page and have access to that. Okay, so in the next part, we are going to start project setup and then just take it from there. Okay, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.